Hey, Everypony, I'm the Pony Fanboy. I fanboy over ponies, and you just listen. And today we're going to be rounding out all the big-named classic shows in recent memory, crossover fanfics that I wanted to talk about. I mean, in the last few years that I've done these Pony Fanboy Reads videos, I've read fanfictions that have either been about or have crossed over shows including Gravity Falls, Rick and Morty, Steven Universe, Star vs. the Forces of Evil, Wander Over Yonder, DuckTales, and now we're looking at the last show that was really popular in the 2010s that had a sizable fan base, that being The Lion Guard, which I've heard was often described as if you took that Disney movie The Lion King and mixed it with My Little Pony Friendship is Magic. So I'm very curious to see how you bring these two shows together. So we're looking at a story that I don't think has an official title this time around. It's just called The Lion Guard and My Little Pony Crossover. The chapters all have names, but the story itself just kind of goes by that title, so Bucket, that's what we're gonna call this video. Now, like a lot of the other shows that I've talked about, I only vaguely know about The Lion King and The Lion Guard, but I've had help from both the reviewer community and my fellow fanboys and fangirls on Planet Goofball explain it to me. I've had help from The Lion King fanboy, as well as Brandon the Bambi Man, who is a fan of the show, and he has done several reviews which were very informative and have helped me get a grasp of this show. And so I feel like I'm kind of prepared for this now. I feel like I know what I'm going into. And this fanfic actually came out in 2019 when both shows, when My Little Pony and Lion Guard ended. So I feel like this is going to be a pretty cool little crossover. It's three chapters long. It's all relatively short. But I'm very excited to see where this goes. So this is The Lion Guard and My Little Pony crossover. Chapter 1, Keon and Twilight. Keon walked toward the waterfall in Hakuna Matata Forest. When he got there, he smiles and runs in the waterfall. Keon walks out of Princess Twilight's mirror and sees Spike and Starlight Glimmer and Twilight and runs to them. "Hey guys," Keon said. "Hey Keon, what's up?" Spike said. "Did anyone follow you?" Starlight asked. "No," Keon said. "Good, we don't want King Simba know your secret and powers," Twilight said. "So that's why you gave me this necklace to keep my powers a secret," Keon said. "Yes," Spike said. "Thank you, so how is Flurryheart?" Keon said. "Good," Twilight said. "Good," Keon said, and walks with Twilight and Spike and Starlight. At the Pride Lands, Simba paced back and forth. "Where is he?" Simba said to himself. "At Ponyville." Keon walks to the mirror. "Bye, you three. See you later," Keon said, and walks in the mirror. In the Pride Lands, Keon ran home fast. When he got there, he got picked up by the Scruff. Keon looks to see his dad. Then he got set down. Simba licks Keon's cheek and nuzzled him. "I was getting worried, son. Where were you?" Simba asked. "At Hakuna Matata Falls," Keon said. Simba nodded. "Okay, son. I believe you," Kimba lied. "Okay," Keon said. Then Keon falls asleep on Simba. Simba smiles and chuckles softly and picks up Keon by the scruff and walks in the den and puts Keon down by him and went to sleep. And now we get to chapter 2, Simba and Keon. Keon woke up to see his mom and sister asleep and gets up and walks the den quietly, then dumps into his dad by accident. "Oops, sorry dad," Keon said. "It's all right, Keon," Simba said. Keon smiles, then Simba nuzzles Keon's head. Keon purrs in confronting until his dad stops. Then Kiara came. "I'm ready for my queen lessons, Daddy," Kiara said. Keon rolls his eyes and looks at his dad. "You should go hang out with your mom, Kiara," Simba said. But you said we were going to do queen lessons," Kiara said. "Sweetie, Keon always hangs out with his lion guard, and your mom, I think it's time for Keon to spend time with me," Simba said. Kiara glares at Keon and growls. "I hate you so much," Kiara said to Keon, and walks towards him. Keon's eyes widen in horror and backs away from Kiara. "Kiara, please don't hurt me again. Please, I'm begging you," Keon whimpers. "Kiara, back away from him now," Simba growled. Kiara walks away to her mother. Keon runs to his dad and hugs him for protection. "Shh, my son," Simba said, and licks Keon's head in confronting until Keon calms down. "So Kiara is hurting you?" Simba asked. "Yes, when she sees you and me hanging out, she gets really jealous. When you're getting a drink or something, she comes at me and hits me in the face. I have scars from some hits," Keon said. Simba lifts Keon's chin, then sees the scars. "Kiara is turning into Scar," Simba thought, then eyes widened. Rafiki was right about Kiara. She has Scar inside of her, Simba thought. And now we're on to chapter 3. Simba knows Kian's secret. Kian walks to Hakuna Matata. When he sees the waterfall and smiles and runs into it. Simba's POV. My eyes widen when Kian went in the waterfall. I walked towards it and gulps, then sees a flash of light, so I ran and hid, then sees Kian walking happily. Now I was anger. I'm so going to talk to Kian when I get the chance. I thought then I sneaky followed Kian to the waterhole, then sees him getting a drink of water. Now's my chance, I thought, and walks up to Kian with an anger and upsetting glare and face. I cleared my throat. Kian looks up in shock. Hi, Dad. What do you need? Kian asked. The truth, I said. Kian's eyes widen and looks at me in shock. The truth, Kian said, with scaredness and backs away. Well, Kian tell him. Someone said evilly. Kian looks behind him to see Kiara. You knew, Kian said. Yes, I did, Kiara growled with an evil smile. Then I see bloody red coming at me. Kian's POV. My eyes widen in horror when I see an evil power coming at Dad. I had no choice but to use my powers. I ran in front of Dad and used my powers to teleport away with Dad to Hakuna Matata Forest by the waterfall. Come on, Dad, we need to go in the waterfall, like now, I said as I ran in the waterfall to Ponyville. Simba's POV. I hesitated, but I trusted my son and runs in the waterfall. Kian and Simba was in the castle. Son, where are we? Simba asked. In Ponyville, Kian said. Hey, Kian, what's up? Spike said as he walks. When Spike walks in, his eyes widen. Kian, who's this? Spike said as he points to Pony Simba. Spike, my sister, is evil. She has Scar's power, Kian said. What? Oh no, back to this guy. Who is he, and why does he look like you? Spike said. Spike, this is my dad, Kian said. Kian, Spike yelled. I know, Spike, what I did was wrong, but what choice you want me to do, Kian said. Go, point Kian, Spike said. Okay, where's Twilight and Starlight, Kian asked. Twilight is with Princess Celestia, and Starlight is at the Crystal Empire, Spike said. Oh, great, Kian said. Sorry, Kian, Spike said. It's fine. Me and Dad will go to the library, Kian said, and walks off. Sorry for pointing, King Simba, Spike said. It's okay, Simba said, and catches up with Kian. And then it ends with a to-be-continued, and I'm not sure if there actually is a follow-up story. I checked, but I couldn't really find one. So, I'm not really sure if this actually has a follow-up, but it does end with a to-be-continued. So, as far as I know, that's the end of the story itself. Overall, I think the idea of these shows crossing over is a unique one. It definitely seems like there is a lot to work with, especially considering that Lion Guard actually does involve a fair amount of magic, so I feel like that way they actually could make this crossover work. But I can definitely see some of my reviewer friends saying that there's kind of a pacing issue. Nowhere near as bad as MLP G3, The World's Biggest Tea Party, because that was just way too long. But it feels like some of the pacing, like the character motivation of this Kiara person, isn't really well explained. It just kind of happens that she's all of a sudden evil. And I know I'm a little bit biased being a The Pony fanboy here, but I kind of would have preferred if there was a little bit more pony stuff going on. It just kind of feels like there wasn't a whole lot of interactions. I mean, there was the interaction at the beginning, and then there's nothing in the second chapter, and then in the third chapter, the only MLP character we get is Kian and Simba interacting with Spike, so there isn't really a whole lot of crossover in there. As of now, I'm not sure what potential fanfiction or crossover I'm going to be reading next time. I actually don't know if we have anything scheduled. So if anyone wants another Pony Fanboy reads, or maybe even a Pony Fanboy review of something MLP or Pony related, feel free to request it in the comments below and let us know what you want us to talk about on any Pony Fanboy videos in the future. Until then, guys, I'm the Pony Fanboy. I fanboy over ponies, and you just listen.